Welcome to ISV Australia. This is me, Brodie. I'll be your tour leader for the second 2 weeks of your trip, the ISV Adventure Tour, where you'll experience more in 2 weeks than most people will in their entire lifetime. After your volunteer projects, we'll travel up the East Coast together on the greatest road trip ever. Our first activity is in Sydney, with a cruise through the famous harbour, taking in some of the famous sights with some free time to explore Australia's largest city. Next, we head to the World Heritage listed Blue Mountains. Our first stop on the way is Featherdale Wildlife Park. Here, you can get up close and personal to Australia's iconic wildlife. That means photos and selfies galore with koalas, kangaroos, wallabies, and heaps more. The Blue Mountains has breathtaking lookouts revealing vast landscapes, rich in biodiversity and Aboriginal history. If the views weren't enough to take your breath away, then our next activity will. A motto of ISV Australia is that life begins at the end of your comfort zone. Here, you'll definitely be living as we step off the end of sheer 150 feet sandstone cliffs.
This is totally cool.
Totally cool?
Totally cool.
Can you try and say that for me in Australian accent?
This is totally cool.
Next, we're heading to the hippie capital of Australia. Think buskers, surfers, and beautiful beaches. It's the most easterly point of Australia, the first place in the country to see the sunrise. Byron Bay is also one of Australia's most environmentally progressive towns. Here you'll have time to relax and take everything in that this place has to offer, or get amongst a favourite Aussie pastime.
In Byron Bay, as part of the OAP package, you guys will have surfing lessons. Now there's no better place in Australia to surf. In fact, National Geographic voted Byron Bay as one of the top 5 learn to surf beaches in the world. And it's a great place to get stuck into it. In ocean waters, they're shared by sea turtles, dolphins, whales, you name it. So let's get stuck into it.
In your free time, you can go sea kayaking, whale watching, explore the local shops, or maybe even some skydiving. Let's keep heading north into Queensland, the Sunshine State. We'll spend 2 days on Fraser Island, staying right near the beach. Yet another World Heritage listed area, Fraser Island is the world's largest sand island. Here, we'll drive through rainforests and up and down beaches that are shared by dingoes. We'll explore rusting shipwrecks, take a dive in champagne pools, look out for dolphins and whales from the top of Indian Head, and float down Eli Creek. On the second day on the island, it's time to get fit as we go hiking across empty stretches of sand dunes and meander through dense rainforests.
Okay, behind me guys here, we have Wangulba Creek. Now, Wangulba Creek is beautiful, crystal clear waters that Fraser Island is famous for. Another reason why Fraser Island is famous is because it's the only place in the world where rainforest grows directly out of sand. So we'll spend some time here checking out this amazing forest. Now, the reason why I'm not talking very loud is because I don't want to kill the amazing rainforest vibes that surround us. So enjoy.
Our next destination is some of Australia's freshest lakes, where you can go paddleboarding or just exfoliate in the sand. Plus, an optional extra is a light plane ride to get a bird's eye view of just how unique this island is. Let's hop on the bus and go even further north, into the tropics. Kicking it off with ocean rafting around the Whitsunday Islands.
The sand here at Whitehaven Beach is 98.6% pure silica. You get treatments like this in Europe, rubbing it on your skin, the world's best exfoliation, and we get to do it right here for free.
If lunch didn't fill you up, you could always have another cultural experience by trying some Aussie bush tucker. Lick an ant.
How would you describe the taste?
It's delicious.
And our final destination, Cairns.
Hey guys, and welcome to Cairns, the gateway to the Great Barrier Reef and the adventure capital of Australia. You'll spend 4 action-packed days here. You'll do things like learn about the history of Australia in terms of Aboriginal culture, and you'll learn about the marine wildlife as well. You'll also spend a day out in the Great Barrier Reef snorkeling at the world's largest marine park.
you'll go whitewater rafting on one of Australia's wildest rivers, and you'll have some free time to go skydiving, bungee jumping, or explore amazing rainforests like the one behind me here. But what am I up to today? We do things a little bit differently here in Australia, so I'm gonna go for a ride in my BMX, so just sit back and enjoy.
Touch there on the bike, that's pretty rare.
Yeah!
Alright, that's enough BMX bungee jumping. Let's take a closer look at the Great Barrier Reef. We'll spend a whole day out exploring the world's largest marine park, so large it's visible from space. You'll get up a lot closer with it as you search for Nemo and all his mates.
This is a great site for you guys to try your introductory scuba dive in waters that are shared by sea turtles, anemone fish, sharks and stingrays. I'm getting back to it. This beautiful sand here from Michaelmas Cay, unfortunately it's quite dissimilar to Whitehaven Beach. It's not made of pure silica. This is the accumulation of hundreds of years of parrotfish poo. Don't you just love nature?
Next up is Jabakai Aboriginal Cultural Park. Here you'll discover Australia's unique Indigenous history. Learn about ancient bush foods and medicine, traditional dances, and how Australia's first people managed to live sustainably for over 40,000 years. Here, you'll have a go at throwing boomerangs and spears. Have you ever tried to throw a boomerang? They're supposed to come back. What's in store next? We've got one of Australia's wettest towns and one of Australia's wildest rivers. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna grab some rafts and we're gonna head down it. You are set for an adrenaline-filled day as you work together to stay afloat in rapids, cutting a path through some of the world's oldest rainforests. By the end of the trip, we'll have to part ways. We start as strangers, but we've made lifelong friends and memories we'll never forget.